Today, I want to share this question with you guys, but it's not just about how to solve this question, it's the idea of why solving this question is particularly interesting, but I will talk about that later. And I also want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video, but more about them later as well. Here, we want to find k so that this cubic equation has a double root. A double root is just a root, but it happens twice. So for example, if we have x cubed plus x squared is equal to 0, we can solve this by first factoring out the x squared, and then we can put this equal to 0, and then put that equal to 0. Right here, x is just equal to negative 1. Right here, we get x is equal to 0, but this is x to the second power. Technically, we will have to say x is equal to 0, x is equal to 0 twice. But you can just write down 0 one time, but it does happen twice. That's why this is a double root to this equation. Now, how do we solve this? Well, you should pause the video and try this first. Done? Okay, here is how I will go solving about this. Firstly, I'm looking at this as a function, but let's just focus on this part. It's the cubic part. And then the k right here is just like a vertical shift. When you graph a cubic function, well, let's say the graph looks like this. I'm not sure, y'all, okay? Just a random graph. Now, if k is positive, then that would be a vertical shift of the graph. So that I want to just bring up enough time. I want this to be touching at the x-axis, and the graph will look like this. Because this way, this will be the double root, and then this will just be the regular root. Okay, perhaps k could also be negative. In that case, I want to shift this down so many times so that the graph will look like this. This would be the double root, and that is just that individual single root. As you can see, what's happening right here, and this is why this question is very interesting. If you can come up with an algebraic solution for this, then you will be able to find the local maximum and local minimum of the cubic function. Because as you can see, once you get the double root, well, it's all about the local min or the local max. But how do we achieve this though? Let's take a look at the blue one, for example. Let's say r is the double root. And right here, the idea is, if you do this algebraically, if you factor it, you must have the factor x minus r squared. All right, and then times something else, which I don't know what it is yet. That's the key. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to let r be the double root. And our goal is to rewrite this polynomial into the form of x minus r squared and then times something else. I don't know what it is yet though. Hopefully we can figure that out. But how can we make this happen though? Well, we can just take this polynomial divided by x minus r twice. And to do so, the best way is of course use the synthetic division. So let's go ahead and do it right here. Let's write down the coefficients. We have 1x to the third power, negative 9x to the second power, 15x to the first power, and then k is just a constant term. And we can just put on the r right here. So bring down the 1, and then do r times 1 and put it here. For synthetic division, we add. So that's just r plus negative 9, like this. And then do the same thing, this times this. We will have r squared minus 9r, and then add it with that. So it's just r squared minus 9r plus 15. And then do it again. And we get r cubed minus 9r squared plus 15r. And then the remainder, which is this, is just all of them together. R cubed minus 9r squared plus 15r plus k. Notice this expression, it's exactly when we plug in r into all the x's, and we want the remainder to be 0 in order for the r to be a root. But not yet, right? We are not looking at this yet, because when we do this, this is only taking this polynomial dividing by x minus r to the first power. We will get this right here as the remainder, but we want to divide this by x minus r to the second power. So what we can do is just look at this and do it again. So synthetic division right here, again dividing by r, go ahead, bring down the 1, I'll just put down this right here, and then r times 1 is still r, and then add them up, be careful this term is 2r minus 9, and then this times this is 2r squared, and then minus 9r, and then add them up. So this and that is 3r squared, and then this and that is negative 18r, and then last is plus 15, and this is the remainder. So if you would like, I will tell you, once you take this divided by x minus r squared, this is the remaining part. This is just 1x, and then plus 2r minus 9. Yeah, that's a constant term. And this is the remainder. But truth to be told, this right here doesn't really matter. Anyways though, does this look familiar? I hope it does. Because if you secretly use the derivative, if you took the derivative of this one time, you actually get this expression, right? With x instead of r. Now, here's the idea. We want to find r so that this is the double root. That means we better have this right here equal to 0. So if you look at this part, in fact, 3r squared minus 18r plus 15 equal to 0, we can solve this very nicely. Factor out 3 first. Minus 6r plus 5 equal to 0. And then just factor this again, we get r minus 1 times r minus 5. So from here, we know r is either equal to 1 or r is equal to 5. So in fact, if r is a double root, when this happens, what we know is this right here, r is either equal to 1 or r is equal to 5 from here. So how can we get a k though? Because you have to find out the k. Well, plugging 1 into here, find out the k, and then plugging here equal to x, and then find the k. That's all. So when we plugging 1 into all the x's, that's 1 minus 9 plus 15, all that's going to be 7, and then plus k is equal to 0, so that means k is equal to negative 7. Now, plugging 5 into all the x's, alright, for all this right here, I would just like to tell you, all that's equal to negative 25, and then plus k is equal to 0, so that means k is equal to positive 25. So to answer the question, we actually have two possible x values to make this work. So what do you guys think? Hopefully you guys all like this. And I know if you guys like math like this, right, you will also like about today's sponsor, Brilliant.work. Brilliant is an online learning platform that helps you to get smarter every day with thousands of interactive lessons in math, science, programming, and more. What I love most is how it forces you to think. You are not just passive reading or watching, you are solving real problems step by step, and that's how real learning should be. Personally, I like Brilliant because it reminds me how I learned math growing up, by playing around with ideas and struggling a little until I really got it. It's that kind of hands-on thinking that helped me become a better problem solver, and I see the same effect when I recommend it to my students. And if you're working on algebra or calculus, their courses are especially strong. Everything is built up to help you really understand. Now, you can try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for 30 days. Go ahead and visit the link brilliant.org/blackpenredpen or scan the QR code on screen, or you can also click on the link in the description. When you do that, you will get 20% off an annual premium subscription, so go ahead and check them out. I want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring today's video. I also want to thank you guys for checking them out. And this is the interesting part I want to tell you guys. This is how we can actually find the local min and local max of a cubic function by just doing algebra. Have a look. let's consider just this portion. And let me show you guys the graph as well. If you want to graph y is equal to x cubed minus 9x squared plus 15x. This is the hard part, because the k is just a vertical shiftment, right? Now, for this, when x is 0, of course it will be 0. And because we have positive coefficient in front of the x cubed, so the graph must be starting down here and then go up. And based on what we did, to get double root, it will be 1 and 5. So we must have 1 and 5. So what's going to happen is that the graph will look like this. Go up, and then at 1 we have a local maximum, and then it has to come back down like this. And then at 5, it must be a local minimum, and then go up, something like this. Now, let me ask you, what's this distance here? It must be 7, because if you add a k to it, k will have to be negative 7 in order to drag this down so that you get a double root at 1. Similarly, when x is equal to 5, this distance here must be negative 25, because k was positive 25, meaning you will have to bring this graph up 25 times in order to make this a double root. So as you can see, we have a local maximum here at 1,7, local minimum here at 5, negative 25 for this function. No calculus needed. Very cool, isn't it?